Well, good evening, everybody. We are about to hear a talk about Debian Science by Andreas Stille. As always, if you want to make a question, just raise your hand, wait for the microphone, and if you can, tell your name and speak to the camera. That's all.
Yeah, thank you. Good evening. So I'm the speaker who has scheduled two events in a row, so you might have seen the video. I'm keen on seeing it again, but now I admit I'm really refreshed to hold this talk. Before I start, I want to say something about my t-shirt, because it's no offense to you. I don't think you are morons, but I always try to use this t-shirt when I'm holding talks to make some reference to the story of this t-shirt. It was, I was joining Debian in 1998, and after 2 years, our well-known and famous glibc maintainer wrote an email, goodbye boys, I will be not alive in about 2 weeks anymore. Nobody was aware of this, and he was ill. He was 21 years old and had a disease which just removed his muscles and so, and at this point I was feeling that I'm a member of a family and not only just of some random geeks which are building operating system. And so I like to choose this t-shirt to remind you on the thing. Well, okay, now to the talk. I got one question in advance. It was, is Debian the distribution of choice for scientists? And well, the answer was no. I want to describe the process how turning Debian into the distribution of choice for scientists. And I would like to try a new term on this, because formerly we had a different term for this stuff I'm talking about, and I would like you to think about whether the Debian integrated solution is something which would fit what I'm describing here. I would like to pronounce it dish, because we provide a dish with a certain flower to you, and the flower in this case is science. So we have some scientific-specific dishes in Debian, and this one of them is, if you are working in the field of biology, you can use the dish Debian Med, and if you are working on geographic information systems, you can use the Debian GIS dish, and there's even for chemistrists the DebiChem project, which tries to work for chemistrists. Well, but for the others, there is not so much. What are the reasons why these specific fields of science are better supported than others? I wouldn't really say that they are better supported regarding the number of packages we have. We have several packages of scientific software, which are really interesting, but I would like to propagate some kind of formalism around these packages, because I think building a distribution is not only adding packages to a package pool. We do very well in this. We have 22,000 packages in the package pool, and it makes no sense to make 30,000, 40,000 without building some substructures. It just does not scale. And so the idea of dish needs some time to propagate or penetrate through the maintainers, that there is something more to do than just packaging. Unfortunately, the advantages are not so widely known as I would like them to be, because, well, people just making some fun of me, you are always talking about the same topic. But is there anything to talk about? And I said, well, not that much, but it's growing, and I hope that it's growing further and further. And most probably, why is there no much more of these disks, is that it's a lot of work to run this, and nobody really wants to do the grunt work of this. So building some web pages, care for some wiki, maintain a mailing list and gather people who are involved in this topic, And so this is a lot of work which is not really fun. You have to write documentation. Who likes this? Hands up, who likes documentation? Come on, who likes documentation? Oh, we have 2, 3. Oh, well, about 5 to 10% likes it. And well, this is a problem. Programming is fun, but running a dish and making it a closed system is really work. And well, we do not have so many people who like to do this work. So the idea of running a Debian Science dish is, well, if there is nobody who cares for specific mathematics or physics for the moment, we try to find a common umbrella for them and try to penetrate the principle to the people. And if then comes somebody and, well, now I want to have a really more specific field for high energy physics or whatever, I start with a Debian physics project or whatever the main will be. And so we could get more easily in this process. What did we had before? Well, 3 years ago at DebConf 5 in Oslo, no, in Helsinki, there was a first talk about Debian Science, and the result of this work was this talk was, well, we had a mailing list with some specific user support and some wiki on web pages, but it was not really alive in the case that, well, it was not really focused on these dish tools, and it was more or less a Slack discussions of scientific issues in Debian. What program could I use to make fine plots, and how can I do 3D plots, or what program are you using to make some regressions or so? And this was basically a user list, English-speaking user list, where scientists was hanging around. Then we had some categorizations of scientific packages, which was nice because I really like this DebTex effort, which was somehow helpful to find those scientific packages you are interested in. But unfortunately, this DebTex technique is not so well known as it should be, and I have certain issues with the maintainability of this. And well, the DebTex is definitely a topic we should elaborate more about, also in this dish effort, and we have to work on this. I take vanilla and strawberry, if you like. Ask the caller of the mobile phone. Then we had DebRAM. DebRAM was also, I just detected DebRAM when I was preparing my first talk about Debian Science. I was not aware that there is such a tool. Who knows DebRAM? That's also not that much. It's even less than the documentation writers. DebRAM is also some effort to classify packages. But I think that DebTex is much more powerful. So my estimation is that DebRAM will die at sooner or later. So what about the Debian Science dish? I think a dish provides straightforward access to the package pool by providing some techniques, which I will have explained in my talk about, well, the formerly so-called CDDs on Tuesday. And the interesting thing is there is no need anymore to search for the interesting packages. If you are a scientist and get some grip on a Debian DVD, you just put it in your computer, install it, then you get a task cell, which do you want a mail server, do you want a desktop environment, do you want a database server, but I just want to do scientific work, what now? And then you start firing up Synaptic or whatever package selecting tool and start seeking for software which might be fit for your purpose. And I don't think it is so much fun to read all these 22,000 package descriptions. It just does not work. You just want to know, well, I need a workstation for my purpose. And we try to provide this by telling the scientists, well, if you are a mathematician, just install one package. It is called Science Mathematics. And this has a dependency to everything which might be interesting for mathematicians. And this is quite easy to do. You can do it with one line or one click in your Synaptic or whatever. Moreover, we have some engagement for packaging more scientific software. Yes, it is right. We need more packages in this field. And we try to make a useful selection of the free software which is available. So it is also about adding packages, but not only. Moreover, we found some techniques to add some user menus or some pre-configuration if it is needed for specific software. So you can tell your scientist, once this science mathematics or science physics package is installed, you get a separate user menu which is called science, and then you find the interesting packages exactly for you. In the field of science, it is not as worse as in the specific sciences, because the original Debian menu has also a science menu. So this is nothing really new here. But if it comes to chemistry or so, you could subcategorize in this menu, which is not possible in the general menu, because we have the menu policy and you can't break it. And we could also do some adapted installer. The installer then does not present the task selection from the default Debian installer, which is desktop system database, whatever. So, but you can then select your specific science, and this does in principle the same as installing this meta package. You can click on the science you want to have and get the box ready and prepared for your scientific purpose. What specific meta packages we currently have? There is science astronomy, science biology, chemistry, electronics, engineering, geography, linguistics. It has not so many packages, but we have this really nice package WordNet, which is unfortunately not so widely known. Mathematics, physics, and robotics. So you probably know that there are some, well, something which you call really a science and something which is not so called. We try the pragmatic approach. If you are working in these fields and we have packages which are important, then we add such a meta package. There are some other things missing, but the missing things are, well, we have no packages in this category, so we do not just invent a meta package to fit the scientific scheme. And we have some kind of common science utilities, for instance, for statistics or typesetting. You will find all the tech stuff in it, and BibTeX and something, what you need for your scientific work, and just for viewing, there are some viewers for scientific data, R and Gnuplot and something like this. So these meta packages are created by the task files, which are the input files for the so-called CDD dev tool. We now here facing the remaining of the old name, custom Debian distribution, that is not renamed because you might not find the new name. And this stuff was basically done in the Extremadura meeting. I'm just mentioning this because I really want to thank you, the Junta de Extremadura, for inviting us, and specifically Frederic Leobé and Dominique Behashemi, who just did the real work, this grunt work I mentioned in the beginning. So further, we did some sensitization of the Debian Science mailing list. Well, you were just a group supporting your users, but we want to try more, go more in the detail and become a real dish and provide some real solutions for the user. This is the main problem, and there were some heavy discussions on this mailing list. Do we really need this? Is this a lot of formalism? And well, our users are happy anyway, but I think we have no real numbers about the happy users and the unhappy users. And so I think it's better to try to do some more than just to expect that users are happy. So, we have, for instance, we have popcorn numbers where we can obtain the numbers of people who installed a specific software and who are actually using it. There's a big difference between the people who have installed the package and are really using it. But these popcorn numbers do not really scale because scientific software is somehow specific, and web browser is used by anybody, or text processing system are using many, many people, but this scientific software has not so many users, and so we do not know whether we have so many happy users or not. So I would like to present you some URLs you might like to look at. This is in principle the Debian wiki of Debian Science. And the second URL is even more important if you want to like to contribute to Debian Science. This link is for you. And this Debian Science group has even a policy invented to make sure that packages which are maintained by this group are all in the same shape. In principle, we discussed in the meeting of Gregor Hermann about group maintaining how groups are working together. And it is good to, if you have a clearly defined policy how the packages look like. And in the, we tried in the Debian Meet dish, which is kind of an example which was taken over for the general scientific dish, a policy which clearly defined, well, what is the maintainer name for a package which is group maintained, so this is a mailing list, and then you have the uploaders, and we have a common version control system, which is in the case of Debian Meet and SVN system. Some people don't like SVN, they know that Git is much more performant and they really like to take Git, and that's why we even decided in the Debian Science effort to use Git. This has some advantage because we can work together. Those people who have, for instance, biological software and would like to work with the Debian Meet team but refuse to do this stupid old-fashioned SVN can check in the Debian Science SVN because, well, it's also science. And so we are working together, and I try to establish this cooperation because it makes no sense to sit on your package and this is our package and this is your package. We want to work together, and then finally it's about users who just can use this package. And so the policy is technical, a little bit different, but we have clearly defined things we want to do, and also the policy contains some, well, how to use this stuff. Well, I'm also, well, I don't really feel old, but I'm over the average of the normal Debian developer, and I'm a little bit unflexible. And what changing from SVN to Git does, it takes time. And well, I know something, why should I take another thing? But if there is some step-by-step introduction, just do this and this and this, this is easy to learn, and so people could get used to it quite easily, and it makes things much easier to get into the group. And this is, well, one piece of the documentation which has to be written, and this is quite important. So if you want to join the Debian Science group, have a look at this policy. Then we have this so-called task overview. I just show you what you can see there. Here you can see the result of the definition of this meta package. You see here astronomy. And for instance, I will show you the content which is just included in Debian. So we have here some astronomical software. And the green bars contain those packages which are inside Debian. So it is quite a lot. I formerly did not know that Debian contained so much astronomical software, And now we come to the yellow part. Well, this color below is yellow in contrast to the green above. The projector is not so good in displaying colors. The video is much better. And the yellow stuff is, well, it's just what we were working on. So we tell our users, well, it is not just included in Debian, but it will be in the near future, and there is even an unofficial package. And if you want, you can install it. We are not really responsible for it, but we are working on it. And then we have some projects on our to-do list which should be included next. And this color is in contrast to the yellow above, this is red. Okay, and we have some WNPP bugs, which means there is somebody working on it. And we have even the person who is responsible for this. And so we are tracking stuff we want to work on. And if you are wondering how we are caring for a user, I can show you we care even for other languages. So for instance, if you want to see this in Japan, I'm really proud this works. We have so many Japanese users who could browse here. This one is not yet translated, but we have a lot of translations. And so you see on the bottom of this page, there are some translated package description in several languages. And what is also my specific duty that if you think, well, this translation is not right, then is there a link fix this translated descriptions. So anybody speak Japanese, and we could try to fix. No, I don't think so. I will not touch this. Or if there is no translation available, then you can translate this description. Well, I could use a different language and whatever. Now you can go to this translation screen and you can start translating this. And my idea behind this is, if you are an expert in a specific field, you actually understand the description of the package. I several times tried to translate descriptions of biological software because it might be needed by some colleagues of mine, but well, I'm a physicist by profession, I do not really understand it. And you can't translate a description which you don't understand. And so I try to involve our users in working for Debian. So if these people translate the description of the package, the next user is able to understand it in its mother language, which is quite important because we actually have a quite high language barrier. And perhaps we can help a little bit in going over this barrier. And this is what I mean with running a dish. It is not only packaging, it is also trying to attract users by showing them what we have and by making them understand what we have. Here also for chemistry, if we are in Argentina, we try the Spanish translation. I never checked whether is something there, but I hope. But this looks quite English to me. Oh, here is a Spanish translation. So, if you are interested, go to these task pages, click the links and translate. This would be helpful. So, this was the task overview. Then, as I said, we did kind of, we took Debian Mate kind of a model for this dish. I will show you some other features which are not yet ported for all the other dishes. I will do so in the next couple of months because we had a very active developer who did a really great job in inventing these web tools. And I'm showing you, for example, this Debian Mate stuff, which will be soon available for the others. We have our group policy and we have the bugs. So if you think that any scientific package has a bug, you will find it on the list of bugs, and so the people who are working on the dish can easily track the bugs which are gathered by all the packages which are interesting for them. So it is sometimes hard because these packages are maintained by a lot of different maintainers. They do not necessarily have to be in this dish group. And so it is a nice feature to have a good overview. These are our interesting packages. Just let's see whether there is some bug or not. And they are even marked with some color scheme, which are important and which are not so important. This is for the bug overview. And then we have a quality assurance page. And this shows how is the status of the package. For instance, we have some difference between the available package and the upstream packages. That means normally somebody has to do some work and build a new package. So also in this view, you get exactly the packages which are interesting for your target user group and have an easy access to the stuff you really have to do or you plan to do. So this overview will also be soon available for the Debian Science Dish. So, and on Tuesday I also presented some interesting stuff about the activity of a mailing list, which is some measure for me, or which I think it should be a good measure to find out how this group is working. And I did this measurement for the Debian Science mailing list. Well, I do not really like that I'm the first of the top 10 posters in the Debian Science group, because my plan was to be specific for the Debian Made group. And you have to concentrate on a project and should not spread all your work in different groups. And so I hope to be able to reduce my work. But what you can see here is there was some certain work done in 2005 when the group was founded. The interesting thing is Charles Plessy, the number two, joined the Debian project in 2006, and he is a very active person in the Debian Made group as well. And I've told you Frederic Leobé, who was working on the task pages, is also very active on this group. And so we are trying to form a strong team which stays in the group and works for the purpose that it's alive. We have other mailing lists which have only a single person more or less posting, and if this person comes for whatever reason idle, becoming a father, getting a new job and have no time anymore, the project is dying, and this is very dangerous. And so we have to try to find some means that to attract people. You see some new peaks. Adam C. Powell was quite new to 2008, and he is supporting the idea of running a dish. And well, I hope that we find some more, and that this mailing list will evolve quite good. The really large peak in 2008 is clearly only influenced by my effort to turning the mailing list into the dish, and it's kind of an artifact. I'm not that active as it might look like. So as I told you, these web tools, which are provided by the dish framework, which are influenced by the task files as a basic source of information, are builded, and the QA tools of the Debian Made dish will be also used quite soon. And so the final plan is to form an instance for upstream developers of scientific software. What do I mean? I had made the experience that in the Debian Made team, upstream developers have no idea how to propagate their software to their users. They put some random tar files on any accessible place in the internet, on a web page, on FTP server, And then these software is hanging around and does not find their users. And so they are quite happy that we are caring about this and trying to build ready-to-install packages. And this really gives the kicks for these upstream developers. And so they are talking to us. And talking to upstream developers is a really good thing. We have seen in the other talk with the SSH thing that we probably do not really talk enough to the upstream developers. And this is quite a good idea if we just to talk to them, write some email, you have done some nice software, we want to integrate it, are you happy about it? We would like you to change this and that. Or could you prepare your software in a way that we can easier work with this, and all this stuff. And this is a very important task, because I think that many maintainers just take software as it is and try to make a package somehow, and the contact to upstream is not so good. If you contact upstream with some Debian Science team, which is an instance and is somehow known, then you have a kind of another position, and the people want you to do something, and they will follow your wishes much easier. Yeah, finally, we want to work on the to-do list of the not yet included packages. It is what I have shown you here. This is our to-do list in the Astronomy case. The packages which are not yet included. This stuff is kind of interesting, because if somebody issues an ITP, I intend to package this or that, then my estimation is half of them will not be solved by an upload, but will be closed after 1 year because, this guy has lost interest or whatever. But if it's checked here, then we will get a grip on it and will not forget it. And so this to-do list is kind of important, because there is so much stuff announced that some people want to do it, and finally they will not doing it. And so some other people could step in and finalize the work. So what's on that to-do list? Well, I think we should just go on with the nice work. This stuff more or less started in the beginning of this year, so it is not that old, and it increased the cooperation in the Debian Made team a lot. It formerly, I was not aware that there is a real team, but now there is. So we want to increase the support of single sciences to create more specific dishes. As I told you in the beginning, science is a large field. So and finally, it is not that useful as if you have specific science, because no scientist needs all the available scientific software. And so as long as there is nobody who really cares about a specific science, we try to be the umbrella for them. But if there is anybody, just raise your hand and join this effort. And there is much experience how to start this. There is even a documentation how to start a dish, which is quite straightforward and I think very good to read. And we also try to advertise the support of sciences in Debian to scientists. So these web pages we created are kind of a nice way to show off. Here we are. This is our stuff. There are a lot of other scientific projects. They just provide a list of package names or whatever. But what is a package name? If you don't know the package, then the name will not enlighten you very much. You need a real description, and we provide the description, and we provide the description translated. And this is a big difference to other projects. And we obviously try to invite these derivatives who also build some scientific distributions, well, join us. We are open. We do not want to try to reinvent the wheel. We want to make just our users happy and not try to compete with anybody else who also do the good work. We are surely not the only team which does good work. There are many other teams, and you find, for instance, there is this Quantian Live CD, which is run by Dirk Ettenbüttel, who is also lurking around on this mailing list. And he is providing a DVD, which is you could put in your computer, and which has a lot of the scientific software included. But well, I think we could support him by doing his work, by making it easier, and this is also helpful. So we want to help and would like to attract people to help our effort. So this, I made this talk a little bit shorter because I really hope that we could discuss a little bit about this stuff. It's actually not a talk, but a BOF, and I really would like to invite you to say your opinions, and perhaps some people on the room who are interested in a specific science, and just ask me. You will find this talk as soon as it is just uploaded but not linked from this page, and I will do this in this evening. So. And this will also be available via the conference management system Penta. So at this point, I'm finished, and I'm happy to answer your question now. Okay.
Hello. So my experience in my field, which is automated theory improving, is that people who are working with these tools always, well, most of the time need the most recent version, which often comes from CVS and is not even officially distributed by upstream. Mm-hmm. So they often take newest versions from CVS to have the newest mm-hmm. features. They often have demanded them themselves mm-hmm. to compile them and mm-hmm. run them locally. So the question is whether such an official distribution, which tends to distribute official releases, will be sufficient for scientists.
Yes, well, there are two extreme situations. I know other people who really wants to stick to their old-fashioned version because this one has provided the data which are needed. So, well, to address your question, it was a long time ago, I think it was in 2004 in Malaga, we were discussing about the technique to, it was not really an idea for realization, but just an idea we're talking about. Release Debian not as a whole, but just as such, in the time called custom Debian distribution, so make very specific releases to, you have a running testing at every time, put for instance scientific software together and have one DVD to hand out to scientists. This is not implemented. I even don't know if it is possible this to implement, but this is at least an idea which exists and which is documented. So if you think this is useful to work on it, well, we could think about this. But it is probably a lot of technical work. It is also interesting for instance, if you are releasing such a distribution for schools. Schools normally tend to change their software in the end of a year of school to prepare the next school year and not correlated with the Debian release cycle. So it makes perfectly sense in several instances to say, well, we release a specific field of Debian and make not this whole release. But if you would go to a mailing list now, I think it would just end up either in a flame war or would die really soon. You would have to present something working first. And alternatively, okay, well, if people have no fear to install Unstable, we try to get the latest version into Unstable. That's why we have these QA pages. You see, here's a QA page. You see where is upstream, and we try to care to get the latest version. And if it makes any sense to use SVN, well, we can try it. Just talk to us.
So maybe a more immediate solution with infrastructure that we already have would be to make extensive use of backports, .org. Mm-hmm. In my experience, people may need not only the very latest term provers, but sometimes actually for versions that lag behind a bit.
Excuse me, let me.
Versions that lag behind a bit.
Yeah.
Because, well, if you see a term prover as a compiler for a language, the language that they accept is extremely incompatible from one release to the other. So upgrading versions is real work on your whole library of proofs that you have already done. So I'm considering whether for these we shouldn't actually package each version as a separate parallel installable a package.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is not implemented, but in principle, I could think about that we could try to do this, because also this, I always see this in this dish effort, and it could be very sensible for other dishes as well. And so if you think about this Debian integrated solutions, we could implement a technique to work, for instance, with snapshots, debian.org, and try to get a specific version from there. I think this is quite doable.
I was really thinking of being able to install several versions in parallel on the same machine.
Okay, yeah.
I'm then considering doing that for Isabel, actually.
Then you could probably pin some version or so, yeah. Well, I don't know. I admit I was not very, I have not thought very deeply about exactly this stuff, but well, feel free to think about it, whether you try to implement something. Anybody else? If not, then I'd like to advertise the next event from Munich, which will be here in 15 minutes, and thank you for attention.